My name is Melissa Hernandez. I'm 18. I'm from Harlem, I guess. Hamilton Heights, right around the corner. And I worked as an intern this year, and I basically helped out with the website, as you saw. So that's my short summary.
I'm Aline Delgado. I'm 18. I'm from the Bronx.
Yanni, 17, Harlem.
Which piece?
Well, mine was one you did not see.
My name is Ambrosine Aguilar. I'm 17, and I did the stop motion video.
Hey, yeah, what's up? How's everyone doing tonight? Like, are you guys having fun? I'm Beatrice Shenfi. I just turned 18, and I'm from the Bronx.
I'm Kia Thomas. I'm 17. I'm from Harlem, and my video was the first video that you guys saw.
Yo, what's up? It's Danielle. No, I'm kidding. I'm Danielle Bagley. I'm 18. I'm from Harlem, and I am the one that was in that music video. But yeah, honestly, I never really knew there was any gardens in Harlem, to be completely honest with you. And being involved in this program, I learned that, you know, you should really get involved with your community. Not only just being a Girl Scout, because I was in Girl Scouts for like 12 years on 152nd in Amsterdam. But being in this program really made me realize that I have to be involved in my community. Because if you're not, you're not gonna have the bond, you're not gonna have the things that you have now. So I would say to this generation, always get involved no matter what it is. If you believe in it, go for it. Go for it. So that's what I learned. Just keep pushing forward. Don't hold back.
I didn't know there was a lot of gardens in Harlem. I knew that this existed and the garden up there, Hope Stevens, existed, but that's about it. Like, nobody ever talked about it, or I never saw anything. And I realized that, like, a lot of gardens are kind of, like, hidden. Just, like, you don't really notice them. And most of them are closed, like, throughout the week, like, most days of the week, most times. And it's, like, I don't know, like, why is that? Like, there's a lot of community gardens, like, in other places in Harlem, like, they're always open. They always have people there. Like, up here, like, there was like one garden I tried to go to and it was never open, even though there was hours on the website. It was never open. Nobody ever took care of it. And I was like, why is that? I don't know. It was just interesting to see that.
Like everyone else said, I didn't know there were any gardens in Harlem at all. But I definitely learned that each garden takes its time. There are people who put in a lot into the garden and expect a lot from the community. But a lot of people in the community don't take advantage of what's in the garden. They're just so, you know, they overlook it. They're so blindsided by the gardens. This summer, I learned that there are gardens who distribute free stuff, like thyme, rosemary, mint, basil, all that stuff. So I feel like people should take advantage of those things, because I definitely did, and I made my mom happy. So that's like one of the things I learned.
This is the first time I actually focused on media and specifically gardens. So that changed my aspect on how we can use media to teach people how to garden and actually in a different way target different people in the community to use gardens as a way to get people together. So.
Like a lot of gardens have memberships where the only way you can benefit from the garden that you go to is if you're affiliated with that garden. A lot of gardens don't let a lot of people join theirs. It's very secluded and like membership only. So like my film was, I interviewed like Nando and a few of other students that are affiliated with this garden. And in this particular garden, they let people go in and out as they please. Like, I don't know if you guys heard, but there were like children in the background playing, and you're allowed to take things from the garden. Like if you were to ask someone, you're allowed to take it, and they give you a small piece, and they keep track of how much they've planted and how much they've given away. So, and I've also learned that like a lot of people may not necessarily know about the gardens or may not really want to like learn about the gardens or actually work in their gardens, because like if you don't work in gardens that are in your neighborhood, they don't really flourish, and they're kind of just like dead space almost.
Me, myself, I didn't work on a lot of the videos myself, but I did work with videos last year in this internship, and I know that it takes a lot of time and teamwork in order to produce any sort of video. And I think what I've learned this year is that patience is a virtue. So I think that it really does like add to what your final project and result will be and how good it's gonna be. And you know, if you take your time with something, give yourself time in your head to think things through, then it comes out all right. So that's what I've learned from production.
And it takes a lot of like stamina, because like after a while, like you get like really like, you know, it kind of gets boring, I'm not gonna lie. Like, no, I'm being so serious, like having to like sit at the computer for like a long time and edit all this footage and then like watch it, and then you look at it and you're just like, okay, I need to put more into it. And then you kind of like, you lose a little bit of creativity and you kind of have to like revamp the, I don't know what the right word is, but you kind of have to like get re-inspired. And I think that takes a lot, because you're putting so much of your time into this and you want people to get something from your films, because you're putting your own time and your work into it along with other people. So I think it takes like a lot of like endurance, like really want to finish it and not feel like, okay, I'm done, I don't really care anymore, because you know, it's a really long process. And after a while you may not feel like, ooh, I'm so interested in this, you know, and like I want to continue it. Sometimes that kind of drains you because it takes so long, but once you finish it and you get to see what you've done, you realize that it was all worth it and the amount of time that you spent on it. So that is what I learned from it.
I'm a lifelong Harlem resident, and I have to say the truth. The Harlem that I'm from, and I'm born and raised in Harlem, is not the Harlem of today. To have gardens is awesome. To see you young people take part in learning a little history of just the gardens, even though you'll need other histories as well, it's really nice to see. And to have y'all bring it back and teach us is something really nice. Now, did you notice, at least I noticed it said Community Board 9, did you notice that there are more gardens that do grow fruits and vegetables, more than just one garden?
We all had to take notes in the gardens that we went to, so you can see like whether or not, if it does require membership, and if it does not, then that means that you are open to go inside the garden whatever times they're open, and you can actually ask for what they
The reason I chose to do a music video is because a lot of people listen to music. Like, this generation, if you put something in a song and you say do it, they're gonna do it. And I think with living in Harlem and moving around, but especially being in Harlem and, you know, growing up seeing things like, oh, you think Harlem's just full of basketball players? And being here in this community, I really realized in the garden, just walking around and learning about things, is that I got inspired to just write a song about it, which I freestyled, which was pretty cool too. But a lot of people, I feel like if they listen to the song, they might think gardening is cool. It's not just for older people or people that are retired. Like, everybody can garden, and you can help your community like that. You could plant food, yeah, you have food, you have water, you have all that, and resources. Use it. That's what the planet is for. Use it. You gotta plant. You plant a seed, grow, and that's even with life. You plant something, you go farther with it. So yeah.
In this day and age, like, there's a lot of like animosity about the youth in our generation, but like, there's like the youth that's like perpetrated in the media, and then there's the youth that actually exists, and there's people in here that do things, and they're youth, and they grow, and they plant things. It's like, it's beautiful, it's nice. They're not just like on Instagram or like listening to song, like they're doing stuff with their lives, and it's nice to see that like those people exist, and it's not just like, oh, we're a selfish generation, self-absorbed. Like, it's refreshing.
I've joined up with the newsletters and stuff that they've done just to know what's going on, and you know, so like now I registered to vote because I'm 18, because I want to, you know, give back to my country because I live here and I don't want to be that person that complains and never puts their part in. So that's how it was before.
I would say that before I joined this program, I wasn't as associated and into community outreach and like helping my community, but when I got like access and like I got into this program, it taught me ways to, this program gave me the chance to actually see how I could add my own, like I could aid in the own growth of garden also. So more like groups like this should be available for other people, so that they can know also that there's stuff like this available for everybody to enjoy.
Before the program, I was not involved whatsoever. After I've gained so much knowledge about gardens in general, and I do plan on, you know, paying my respects back by helping the gardens that need help, the gardens that are just hidden and not just abandoned, and gardens that aren't abandoned and are actually helping the community.
After like the program, I feel like I do want to get involved. Like, this is a really pretty garden, and I would want to, there's like the program at the Brotherhood Sister Stole that deals with the garden. Like, I would want to join it. I would want to help out. It's really cool. And just, there's just a lot of gardens that I went to that I feel like could use a lot of help. Like, they say that they're open and they're not because they don't have volunteers, and it would be pretty cool to volunteer for a garden, like help grow things. And
well, honestly, I was in Girl Scouts, but like, I would think it was like a thing mom told me to do. Go to Girl Scouts, sell cookies, and help people, right? But as I gotten older, I realized being in a community really does help you. It helps you grow as a person, it helps you realize that there's other cultures around you and not be so close-minded to things. And I think, like before, yeah, community, you know. But like I said, being older and seeing everything and like being in this garden makes me want to come here, get all my close friends instead of going to Times Square, wasting my money. I could come here, have fun, and plant. And, you know, I really see myself doing that in college as well, being involved with like a green club or anything just to help people. Because at the end of the day, when you give back to your community or you're just helping someone, you feel good about it. And you don't feel bad about it. It's like, oh, I helped somebody today. Okay. Like, and I'm happy with that. So I can see myself really doing that.